In order to access the pizza box template, you want to be in Illustrator and go to File, New from Template, choose Blank Templates, choose Boxes, and in the Boxes template you have three artboards. So you only want the pizza box artboard, and you want to delete the other artboards. So go to Document Setup, choose Edit Artboards, click on the artboard you would like to delete, hit Delete on the keyboard, do that for the other box that you want to delete, go to the Selection tool to click and drag over the remaining items that you don't want on your document. All right, so you're left with a single artboard that has a pizza box template. And in the layers window, that template is called a die line. So what it means is that these black outlines of the box indicate places where a large die would, once the box is printed, a die would come down and cut it out. The dotted lines are places where the box would be folded. So it's important to understand the parts of the box, that this part, this large square on the right, is going to be the bottom of the box, and these little thin rectangles at the top and the bottom, those are cutouts where these tabs would fold over. So these this would be the inside of the side of the box. This would be the top of the box, and then these would be sides. This. Okay, so we do not want to work on the die line layer, and you can see in Illustrator, it's very similar to Photoshop. There's these little eye icons where we can toggle the visibility of the layer. So if I click on this eye icon, it toggles the die line layer off so that we can't see it. So we do want this visible so that we understand the contours of our pizza box, but we don't want to work directly on it. So I'm going to click next to the eye icon and lock that layer, so I can't accidentally select it. Now there's already a layer below that die line layer, which is going to be our artwork layer. That's the layer that we're going to work on. So I'm going to double click that name and just rename it artwork. Make sure that that layer is selected. And then you want to zoom in so that you're comfortable working. And mainly we're going to focus on the cover or the top of the box. And the first thing that I'm going to show you is that if you would like to place a background color on your box, you're going to need to create a closed shape. And you can see that this cover is not a perfect rectangle. There are little indents here. So instead of using the rectangle tool, which is what, if this was just a rectangle or a square, you know, it would be relatively easy to go ahead and just drag a rectangle out from one side to the other and then create a fill. So let's say I want my box to be red. We wouldn't want a stroke on this. And if I deselect that, I can see that since my artwork layer is below my die line layer, I can see that die line contour above it. So this is not a stroke that I've applied to my shape here. If I did have a stroke applied, which really wouldn't be a good idea, And the default is 1 point, and it's really getting confusing as to what is the actual die line and what is a stroke on my shape. So if you're going to put a background color on your box, you just want to make sure that you have the stroke at set to none. And this is something that we don't want. So what the requirement is for the assignment is that everything stays within the contour of this die line, because we're going to imagine that this is a concept that we might present to a client. So we want it to look neat and clean and as accurate as possible. So if I select the rectangle and then I choose the pen tool and I choose add anchor point, and then I click on the, and I'm going to zoom in quite a bit so it's easy to see this. If I click right here on this path, you can see another anchor point appears. It's the same thing as this anchor point at the corner, and the anchor point is changing the direction of our path. So let me make another anchor point right here at this intersection. Okay, so now I've got three anchor points. I've got the two that I created, and then I've got the original one that's outside of the contour of the box. And what I'm going to do, and I'm already in this, I'm going to click on the Delete Anchor Point tool and just delete that anchor point. And when I do that, my path changes direction and it runs between the two new anchor points, and then now it's conforming to the shape of my box. All right, let me go down to the bottom, and I've got the same thing here. And I also can see that this is, because when I placed this rectangle, I was too far away. So it was hard to tell whether I was inside the contours of this box. So what I'm going to do, I'm in the direct selection tool. I see this middle anchor point here, and I'm just going to click and drag that so that it's the edge of that is behind the die line. All right, so what I do need to do is I need to select this again and then create, add two anchor points, one at each intersection here, so that I can change the direction of my line. So I'm going to go back to my pen tool, choose add anchor point, click directly on this path, and then we don't need this original anchor point, so I'm going to choose the Delete Anchor Point tool and click on that. All right, so now I have my background color conforming very accurately to the shape of my die line, and I want to make sure that I zoom in and that I don't have any places where there's a gap like this. So zoom in and out as needed. What I'm looking for is that anchor point in the middle here that I can grab, and I can just click and drag that so that it's directly behind my die line. Okay, so if you wanted to, let's say your pizza box was red and these are the sides of the box, and let's say you wanted to add red to the sides of the box, then you would do something similar. These sides are more actually rectangles. So I'll just do one of these so you can see. I'm just going to the rectangle tool and I'm clicking and dragging to draw out a rectangle shape. And since I already have my fill set at red, it's already filled with color. Again, I want to make sure that my stroke is at none for these shapes, anything that's a background shape. And then I want to zoom in, go to the selection tool, and then just make sure that I modify the shape or the size of this if it goes beyond the die lines or there's any kind of a white gap there. Just want to make sure that it looks neat. That looks Right, that looks about right. I'll just make a minor adjustment here. Oops. Okay, so I've got my cover, or the top of my box, with a red background.